The control tower looks like it shouldn't be standing. Much of the terminal building isn't. This was the international airport on the northern outskirts of Donetsk. September's ceasefire has not stopped shells and rockets falling here. The separatist guns have maintained a daily bombardment, smashing through buildings, tearing up the tarmac. Somehow, Ukrainian government forces have held on. For weeks, this has been the most intensely contested territory in Ukraine, but that smoke shows the fighting isn't just localized to the airport. All along its southern and eastern perimeter are residential and industrial areas, and the separatists are staging their operations from among those homes and buildings. And it's also often where the Ukrainian military fires into when they're trying to hit them back. On the streets near the airport, some locals no longer react as heavy weapons fire and fall nearby. This is a dangerous and difficult place to live. It's the third time they hit the area, this man says. We have no electricity and water. Artillery and rocket fire has ripped open homes on almost every street, exposing them to the freezing late autumn air. In a damaged apartment building, we find three terrified women. They tell me they live on the front line. The shelling never stops. This woman begs the world to help. Please don't let them kill us for nothing, she says. The people here believe Ukrainian government forces are deliberately targeting civilians, but separatist fighters are close. From this vantage point in a residential area, we hear outgoing artillery fired repeatedly. Enormous amounts of firepower have been exchanged here, but it's unclear for what purpose. Neither side is claiming new territory, while homes and infrastructure are destroyed, and hatreds deepen. Bill Black, CNN, Donetsk, Eastern Ukraine.